Hey guys, so on Friday I wasn't feeling super great. Some of you noticed that I had the whole voice cracking thing. I assumed it was allergies. On Saturday I spent most of the day in bed, and Sunday today I have barely been able to do terribly, like a whole bunch of stuff. So I reached out to the nurse. She wants me to get my test done on Monday for, of course, the dreaded COVID. I suspect I just have toddler snot. So at 8:45 on Monday, I'll be getting my COVID test. And if I'm negative, I can return to work. If I'm positive, I'll be out for a couple of days. Regardless, I wanted you guys to be able to prepare for your upcoming exam on Tuesday, which is tomorrow when you're seeing this video. So let's go over that. So I'm going to walk you through the structure real quick on this exam. You're going to have two questions, and I'm going to ask you to describe in detail one person that you like and one person you don't like. For each person, you will describe the following things: the way they look, the way they act. This includes their personality, and maybe things they do to you. And then you will include things that they like or don't like. So those three things for two people. So your exam should be 4 to 6 sentences per person. It's a different version of the quiz because I want more detail for the two people. And so the exam will be like last time on the quiz. You'll have one question where you test your audio out, where you hit the record button and make sure that you can be heard, that everything's going good, that your headset works. The second question is going to be somebody that you like. The third question is going to be somebody you don't like. Ideally, they're people in your classroom or people that I teach so that I can understand what you're saying. So right now, I'm gonna pick somebody from Bell One who has a good sense of humor about themselves. So let's say Cameron Mano is somebody who I like. Hi, Cameron. This is for you. So I would say, Cameron es muy extrovertido. He's very extroverted. Cameron tiene pelo largo. He has long hair. Cameron es muy simpático. He's very kind. Cameron, and now I'm going to make some stuff up. Cameron le gusta jugar Minecraft. Cameron le gusta comer pizza. Cameron le gusta las chicas mucho. Cameron likes the girls a lot. Y Cameron es muy cómico, and Cameron's very funny. You'll notice that there's not like a whole bunch of like structure, like I did the things I liked first, followed by the things I liked about Cameron, followed by the things that Cameron likes to do. I could even say Cameron no le gusta Senor Kohler. Cameron doesn't like Mr. Kohler. Like I could have said that because it's some of the things he likes and doesn't like. You'll notice that took me maybe 15 to 30 seconds to do. I don't expect this speaking exam to be huge. You'll have a much more aggressive one on your final when we get to next week on Thursday and Friday. So let's continue on to things I don't like. So I'm going to talk about myself as if I'm a student. So a student could say, Senor Kohler, as this person they don't like, by the way, Senor Kohler es muy cruel. No es cómico. Y no le gusta los estudiantes. And he doesn't like the students. That's it. That's like a C right there. Like I've given three lines, I'm done, check the box, and I roll out. When I make this video, I'll attach the rubric for the speaking thing as well, so you guys can see kind of what I'm looking for. And so for today, what I'm doing is the biggest issue most of you guys are having are the following two things. The first one is you guys are really struggling with the matching gender and plurality. So what I mean by that is, for example, certain genders like attractivo, certain, sorry, adjectives like attractivo, attractive, depends if it's a girl or a boy. So if it's a girl, who's attractive is attractiva. So if I wanted to say that there was a friend of mine in class ella es atractiva. Now, if it was a guy, and I want to say he's attractive, because saying a guy's attractive is perfectly acceptable if you're a guy, él es atractivo. Él es atractivo. So failing to do the gender issue can become a serious problem later on in Spanish. And it can confuse dialogues, and it makes some hilarious videos later on. The second issue you're having when it comes to the to nouns is once you have a noun that's plural. So, for example, if I had chicos, that means there's at least two. Chicos means children or kids. It doesn't mean they're all boys. There could be like one girl and 10 boys, or it could be one boy and 10 girls, or it could be 75 boys and 38 girls. Who knows? Who cares? It just means there's at least two, and one of them's a boy. Now, if I'm talking about the girls' softball team, I would say las chicas que juegan softball. Notice it's chicas, because girls play softball, boys play baseball. Pretty sure boys don't play softball until they're older and get beat out. Although it looks really challenging anyway, throw that. Anyway, separate issue. So make sure that when you have plurals, you make sure that your noun is plural. The verb matches it as well as the adjective. So if it's the softball girls are athletic, okay, I would say las chicas que juegan softball son atléticas. The girls who play softball are athletic. Okay. Those are the major issues when it comes to nouns and verbs. The second issue that I've seen on your exams is when to use ser versus a star. So a lot of you guys would say, él es feliz, which means he's a happy person. That could be true. Some people like, you know, Mr. Hoffer, they're just generally kind of happy people. Like if they're sad, something bad's gone down. Some people are generally kind of jerks, like Mr. Kohler. So that would be está cruel, is he was cruel that day because his dog died, versus es cruel, he's just a cold-hearted jerk. Deal with it. So I've attached two videos to today's lesson that specifically focus on the matching adjectives with their genders, and I'm going to attach an additional one here for ser versus star. I'm going to make two of them practices and one of them a quiz grade, so that way they get done. And I hope that I'm there for the end of bell one, if not bell two and three, because while I don't feel great, I don't think I have, you know, anything serious. So I look forward to seeing you guys hopefully Monday, if not Tuesday. Thank you so much.